new report from The Guardian explained how our use of torture against detainees in the war on terror occasionally crossed the line into human medical experimentation. For more on this story, let's go now to Michael Burg. So, Michael, earlier this week, the Senate finally, after sitting on this for years, comes out and says, okay, we are going to make torture illegal again, even though it was always technically illegal, regardless of what Alberto Gonzalez or George Tenet wants to tell us. Torture has always been illegal. But this vote came a couple days after we got this new, very damning report from The Guardian that showed possibly one of the ugliest sides of the torture techniques of the Bush administration. Lay this new report out for us. What do we know just this week?
Well, we know that unfortunately our country has made a turn down a very, very dark hallway with this torture. What we do know from the Guardian report is that it was authorized by the CIA, that it was authorized obviously all the way up to Dick Cheney and the president. And we also know that they were doing what could be conceivably called medical experimentation on these humans to determine what would happen to them under certain circumstances. They had doctor and medical personnel when they were torturing people who were being detained and waterboarding them, keeping them underwater. And of course, the real horrible part of all this is that we violated our own agreements, we violated the law, and we, by everyone's admission, they got absolutely no information that was helpful with regard to terrorists. And so, go ahead, I'm sorry.
Well, I was going to say, so they almost treated this as if it was a clinical trial. You know, let's see what happens when we leave them locked in a freezer for 3 days. You know, like you would with a pharmaceutical. Let's take 10 people, give them this drug, and see what happens. So they were just using these human beings who, most of them at the time, had been accused of absolutely nothing, just kind of rounded up and sent down to Guantanamo or Abu Ghraib or wherever. And it was just research for them. These weren't human beings. These were guinea pigs, essentially.
Well, it reminded me, really, when you read the report by The Guardian, and you know, I'm very hesitant to say this, but, you know, we know of other wars and human experimentation is something that is illegal and immoral and should not be part of the United States ever, ever, ever. We know in Germany they did it. We know it was done in other wars. And we, in the United States, when I was brought up, we were saying, you know what, we don't torture people. We have rules. We have compacts of how we treat people. And these were completely ignored by Dick Cheney, who is, quite frankly, the worst vice president in the history of this country. He's done more to destroy the world. These sort of things are the things that, unfortunately, turn the world against the United States. And it's not, and some people want to argue that the disclosure by The Guardian or by others is really what does it. But that's not the truth. The truth, what does it, is doing it. You know, we live in a free society, and disclosure of these horrible, horrible facts are important. What's amazing to me is that when the vote was taken by the Senate, I think it was yesterday, day before, I believe it was 72 to 28. So while it was overwhelming, there were 28 senators.
21. We had 21.
I'm sorry, 79
Republicans.
Right, 21 senators came out and said, "I don't want to make torture illegal in this country." They came out and said, "I think we should allow torture," and that to me is disgusting. It's criminal. Those senators should not be allowed to sit in the U.S. Senate. They've disgraced the U.S. Senate by that vote because we, America, the greatest country in the world, the country that's on the side of right and fight for people's individual rights and for decency, they have said we should violate that. Even under the circumstances that exist here, where these kind of human experimentation and torture was done, and not one single piece of evidence that could be used was gotten as a result of that human experimentation and torture.
Well, I think what's interesting is that we had Marco Rubio was absent from the vote. He was out campaigning, couldn't be bothered with it. But his office did say, hey, had he been there, he absolutely would have voted against this you can't torture legislation. So we have Marco Rubio and Lindsey Graham. Both Lindsey Graham did vote against it. Rubio said he would have. So both of these two people running for president who think it's absolutely acceptable to take another human being, subject him to all kinds of torture bordering on human experimentation. And so I guess the question here is this going to affect them during the campaign, or does the Republican base simply not care about the fact that they think it's okay to torture?
I believe in the American people. I think the American people, I was raised, you know, in a very, very middle-class neighborhood in Chicago. We didn't have much. You know what? We were raised to know that America was the bright shining light in the world. That while other countries may torture, we don't torture people. While other countries may spy on their people, we don't do that. When I was a kid, I remember hearing about how the Russians would spy on people. We heard about the Gulag. We heard about how in Nazi Germany, all the human experimentations. And we, America, Captain America, we're on top of that. And we don't do those sort of things because that's not how our society works. Well, let me just tell you, those 21 senators should be attacked for that vote. Because John McCain, who was in an encampment for all those years, and Senator Feingold, that's a bipartisan. He understands what it's like to be in a prisoner of war camp. And while I may disagree with him on many, many issues, I respect his willingness to sponsor that bill and to come out and say, in America, we don't do that. And I do think it will be a campaign issue. It should be a campaign issue. And those Republicans who, I believe very strongly in this country that we don't cross that line should make it a campaign issue in the presidential campaign.
Well, you know, it's very admirable for John McCain to come out this and fight so hard for this legislation, which he's done in the past as well, because he is one of the only people that I'm aware of that is in the U.S. Senate that has both the physical and the psychological scars that he's carried with him for decades of torture. Nobody in that U.S. Senate understands the issue better than him. But when somebody like that who's been through it, who comes out and says, I don't care what you think this person did, you cannot do this to them, I'm going to agree with him 100% of the time on that.
We're a society of laws, and we violated the law. And quite honestly, and I don't agree with President Obama on everything, but coming out and admitting what was done here and having John McCain and others stand up and say, what's amazing, we even had to have the vote. It was already illegal.
Right.
You know, we may have the attorney general who may try to change the law with his interpretation, or Dick Cheney, who's already come out and said, oh, we ought to keep torturing people, even if it doesn't work. It didn't work. That's the one thing we learned also, is they didn't get one shred of information that they could use. So what are they gaining? They're not gaining anything. What they're doing is they're losing, because the fact that we torture those people, it turns around just the opposite. People look at us and look at America in a different light. We are not the bright shining star anymore. We're willing to go down into the dark of Hades and go out there and torture people. That turns people against America. What America should be doing is helping those people, helping them in terms of food and water and clothes, and make them understand the America that we all understood when we grew up was the America that fought for people and have a legal society, not allowing people to torture other people, not being able to look at what happened with the NSA. We just had that vote. And again, Rand Paul may not be my choice, but he stood up to it and they voted to stop the spying on the American people. And again, this is not what America stands for. So when we look at these Republicans that are in the presidential race or in the Senate that are for spying on their own people, the citizenry, the farmer out in his farm on the phone, they're spying on him. the person who's doing nothing wrong. They're recording their telephone calls. This is not the America that I understood when I grew up. It's not the America we need for the future. And those Republicans who believe that what America should stand for is spying on their own citizens and torturing people, that is something that should be rejected by the American people. And I believe that if those become issues in this campaign, it will be rejected. I have confidence in both Republicans and Democrats and independents that that's not the America that we want to have here.
You know, it's really great that we've seen in just the last 2 weeks, you know, the end to two horrible Bush-era policies. And I hope in the coming weeks, there's even more. Michael Burg, thank you for telling us this story today.